Randy Snyder, the head girls basketball coach for the Kemper Knights, joining us here in the postgame tonight. Randy, a hard-fought 10-point victory. A lot of times you win by 10, you don't think that it's that tough of a ball game, but down by 19 in the second quarter, rally all the way back to get the win tonight against a good ball club. What's this show about your ball club?
Well, this says about what their heart is. They got a lot of heart. We just told them to keep fighting the first half. They just couldn't miss. And Ferguson girls is as good as everybody says she is. You know, she's tough to guard, 0-4, but I thought the girls made nice adjustments. No, the coach and I gave them ideas what to do, but they went on and they executed. I thought it showed a lot of experience out of a bunch of younger kids.
Was it just the success she was having in the first half, or was it that combined with the foul trouble that you were having in the first half that made you go to that box and won there in the second half?
You know, it was probably a blessing in disguise. You know, we were just in so much foul trouble, so we had to make an adjustment in box and one. You know, we made some small adjustments and helping off in the first half. And she's just so good, so between Claire Ludwig and Katie Tigas and Abby Derner, I thought they did a great job. I think they gave up 5 points in the second half.
Coach, were you surprised in the first half? It seemed like Ferguson did a lot of the ball handling. In the second half, they didn't really get her the ball at the perimeter much. They really tried to work her in the lane. Were you surprised that when they were struggling offensively, they didn't try to get the ball in her hands and let her create a little more?
I attributed that, some of that to us. I thought we did a better job of guiding her and making her work. I thought at the end of the game, the last 4 minutes, we really showed how hard she was. I just give our girls credit. It wasn't a 19-point shot or a 14-point shot. We had to grind it out and find a way to win. And defensively, you know, we just found a way to at the end of the win. We made our free throws. I think we shot 85% of free throw line, knock on wood, which is what it's going to take to be competing in this conference.
Randy kept pounding the ball inside. You guys never gave up on Maria in the low post or even Bauer here tonight.
Well, Maria's got to touch the ball. We just asked our kids to do it. About after Maria caught the ball, how many girls were guarding her. There was triple teams and double teams, and we're just asking our girls, after Maria catches it, are they relocating for a shot, or what are they doing? It just seems like we stood a lot for a while, and if we keep moving, and Maria's going to give it up, it's just triple teams. So I just thought Maria did a nice job of being unselfish at times, but also being selfish enough to know when to score.
Randy, a lot of different players stepped up for you tonight in this win, but I thought Katie Tigas, especially midway through that fourth quarter, that driving bucket, then she got in there all the way from the top to fight Ferguson for that rebound and get the tie up, and then all the free throws down the stretch, really was huge for you here tonight.
Yeah, big shot, Tigas, man. I'll tell you what, that was a huge shot, huge.
Yep.
Have the courage to go in there and do that, and all the free throws. She just keeps getting a little better all the time. You know, she just has learned that she can't have an agenda about herself. She just got to let the game come to her. You can't tell kids that they got to get off more shots. She just got to look and see what they can do. I thought she showed a lot of maturity when she was open. She shot the ball and she had the lane. She went to the lane and when she was double teamed, she took it. You know, I thought she showed some growth. I love the way she's getting a little better in shape. I thought Abby Durham coming off the bench, Courtney Snyder coming off the bench. Now, we have three girls. I believe we had three girls foul, two for sure. Overmore fouls out, and you know, to be successful this year, we have to have a lot of contributions.
And you certainly got those here tonight. Again, what a rally, down 19 in that first half to come back and get the win here tonight.
Yeah, it's, you know, the win by 10, that's a 29-point swing. You don't see that in girls' basketball. But like I said, give the girls credit. They played smart basketball.
Well, Randy, appreciate you joining us here tonight. Congratulations. Look forward to seeing you later on this week.
Well, thanks a lot for the coverage, Jeff. Thank you very much.
Head coach Randy Snyder again.